Hey, brothers and sisters. I have a very interesting article for you from technocracy.news entitled The UN World Economic Forum Call for a New Global Social Contract with, quote, no one left behind. Now, obviously, the leave no one behind makes us think of those left behind after the rapture of the church. So, in our common agenda, UN Secretary General paints a picture of a world facing a choice between collapse and breakthrough. If we make the wrong choice, we will be hit by a mutating virus repeatedly haunting us. Health systems will not be able to handle the pressure, and the vaccines will be distributed unequally. The planet will heat up, resulting in melting polar ice caps, floods, droughts, cyclones, animal species extinction, and wasted human lives. Poverty will increase, protest will be crushed, human rights will be neglected, while the development of new forms of warfare will prevent all peace initiatives. So here they're painting this doom and gloom scenario on why you should jump on board to their agenda. What they don't know is this is exactly what the Bible prophesies will happen in the tribulation. But going on, but if we choose the model of the UN and the World Economic Forum, we are promised paradise, they say. A greener, safer, and better world with a rapid crisis response, including a health system where vaccines are available to all, where fossil fuels are phased out, and global average temperatures are kept in check. The reasoning is similar to what Klaus Schwab expressed during the Declaration of the Great Reset. Quote, we have a choice to remain passive, which would lead to the amplification of many of the trends we see today. Polarization, nationalism, racism, and ultimately increasing social unrest and conflicts. But we have another choice. We can build a new social contract, he says. Now, to meet the goals of the Agenda 2030, everyone must be involved. In our common agenda, the first commitment out of the 12 is leave no one behind. Again, it's very interesting wording here concerning the rapture of the church. This concerns a renewed social contract between governments and citizens, which, according to the UN, should be based on human rights, including a social safety net with healthcare, income security, housing, education, and decent work. Who can say no to that? But on closer inspection, the contract seems to be mostly about being digitally connected to the worldwide control system, being traded with, quote, right values, housed in a, quote, smart city with surveillance, and promised a universal basic income. If, and that word if, you obediently follow all orders from the UN. It is a social contract for the digital age where citizens' rights and obligations must be adapted to today's needs with lifelong learning, a fair and inclusive transition to a zero carbon society, and a responsible use of technology, where the spread of false information must be prevented. In other words, it's a contract where you are to blindly accept what the government imposes on you and where you will be excluded from taking part in both community service and financial services if you refuse or have a different opinion. I just find it so interesting, brothers and sisters, that this new social contract is regarding having no one left behind, when in fact everybody left behind after the rapture, the majority of them will have to sign on to this new global social contract. This will obviously lead to the rise of the Antichrist, the one world government, the one world economy, and the one world religion. Again, always look for these key phrases when studying their trends. And I will include the link here for this article. It's a little bit longer than I'm reading, but again, it's very interesting and very alarming. God bless.